violence toward the children of men, would you tell somebody, he's done wonderful things for me? Come on, you need to testify to somebody. I've made it 364 days because the Lord was doing some wonderful things for me. Would you reach over and grab somebody's other hand and tell them, I don't care what you're going through, I don't care what you have or don't have, all I want you to know is praise is necessary. If you want to get out of what you're in, you'll praise him until he shows up. Because the Bible says he inhabits the praises of his people. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's going to be liberty. So if you want to be free of it, you will have to bless him. You will have to give him praise. You will have to glorify God. Come on in here. Glorify him. Oh, bless the Lord. Oh, my soul. Come on. Come on. Come on. It's an act of gratitude, adoration, commendation, extolling. It's an act of celebration. One definition puts it like this: it's a show of gratitude and homage to a God who's been good. Do you know what the word homage means? Homage means reverence and respect. So if you respect God at all, and because of what he's already done, I know I'm working overtime, but I see some folk who ain't yet gotten caught up in the celebration. And let me explain it to you. I'm not talking about dancing. I'm talking about the fact that your body language says, I appreciate all that God has done for me. It's a posture. It's an attitude. So when I turn and look, I expect to see a posture of folk who are just appreciative of what God has done, knowing that if the Lord had not done it, if God had not done it, if the Lord had not stepped in when he stepped in,